celebration, a breath of fresh spring air, taken from the libretto of the Aaron Copland opera, The Tender Land. The text of the celebration dance, which begins Act Two, reads, "Stomp your foot upon the floor, throw the windows open, take a breath of fresh, clean air, and dance around the room." We're so very glad that you're here with us this evening in this beautiful setting, which in itself is an artistic expression of praise to our Creator, the author of all artistic expression. While you are here, you might want to take a few moments to explore the art, the architecture, and of course the stained glass of this hallowed place of worship. All is dedicated as a gift of love, passion, and praise for the eternal God. Let us begin by standing for our opening prayer. So if you would, please stand if you are able, or stand in spirit if not, and join me. Creator God, we praise you. We praise you in your sanctuary, and we praise you in your mighty heavens. We praise you, Lord, for your acts of power, and we praise you for your everlasting greatness. We praise you with the sounding of the trumpet and with the harp and flute. We declare that everything that has breath praises you. Hallelujah. Alleluia. Amen. If you would wish to remain standing as we sing together, "When in our music God is glorified." And if you read music, it is in the hymnals, and it is number 68. Thank you. then become real. Does it happen all at once like being wound up? Rabbit asked. Or bit by bit? It doesn't happen all at once, said the skin horse. You become. It takes a long time. That's why it doesn't often happen to people who break easily, or have sharp edges, or who have to be carefully kept. Generally, by the time you are real, most of your hair has been lugged off, and your eyes drop out, and you get loose in the joints, and very shabby. But these things don't matter at all.
think the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, and the walls come tumbling down.
Joshua fit the battle of Jericho,
he fit the battle of Jericho,
Jericho, Jericho.
Joshua shook the battle of Jericho, he fit the battle, and the walls come tumbling down. You may talk about your man of Gideon, you may talk about your man of Saul.
To the turtle dove that listens while she emotes on the moon. Oh, from out the sounding cells, what a gush of euphony voluminously wells, how it swells, how it dwells on the future, how it tells of the rapture that impels to the swinging and the ringing of the bells, 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 to the rhyming and the chiming of the many wondrous bells.
Thank you.
the ages, women have had a particular and profound impact on the world of arts. Listen to these inspiring quotes from famous women in music. Billie Holiday, "You can't copy anybody and end with anything. If you copy, it means you're working without any really feeling of your own. No two people on earth are alike, and it's got to be that way in music, or it just isn't music." Joni Mitchell, "You could write a song about some of the emotional experience you are having, but it would not be a good song until it went through a period of sensitivity to a moment of clarity. Without that moment of clarity to contribute to the song, it's just pretty noise." Aretha Franklin, "If a song's about something I've experienced or that could have happened to me, it's good. But if it's alien to me, I couldn't lend anything to it, because that's what the soul of music is all about." Judy Garland, "Always be a first-rate version of yourself instead of a second-rate version of somebody else."
Thank you.
Profound words to add to the descriptions of music. It's said that even the fiercest person can be brought to tears by the power of music. Listen to these words. Where words fail, music speaks. Hans Christian Andersen. Music is the language of the spirit. It opens the secret of life, bringing peace, abolishing strife. Cahill Gibran. Music, once admitted to the soul, becomes a sort of spirit and never dies. Edward Bulwer Lytton. Music touches us emotionally where words alone cannot. Johnny Depp. Music produces a kind of pleasure without which human nature cannot survive. Confucius. Music is the universal language of mankind. Henry Wadsworth Longfellow.
Thank you.
Shelley wrote some of the most profound words ever written about music in his most well-known and beloved poem, set many times by musicians and composers. Music, when soft voices die, vibrates in the memory. Odors, when sweet violets sicken, live within the sense they quicken. Rose leaves, when the rose is dead, are heaped for the beloved's bed. And so thy thoughts, when thou art gone, love itself shall slumber on.
Thank you.
Edward Elgar composed his variations on an original theme, Opus 36, popularly known as the Enigma Variations, between October of 1898 and February of 1899. It is a work comprising 14 variations on an original theme. Elgar dedicated the work to my friends pictured within, each variation being a musical sketch of one of his circle of close acquaintances. Those portrayed include Elgar's wife, Alice, his friend and publisher, Augustus J. Yeager, and even Elgar himself. In a program note for a performance in 1911, Elgar wrote, "This work, commenced in a spirit of humor and continued in deep seriousness, contains sketches of the composer's friends. It may be understood that these personages comment or reflect on the original theme, and each one attempts a solution of the enigma," for so the theme is called. "The sketches are not portraits, but each variation contains a distinct idea founded on some particular personality or perhaps on some incident known only to two people. This is the basis of the composition. But the work may be listened to as a piece of music, apart from any extraneous consideration. Tonight, we hear it set with the words of the communion antiphon, Lux Aeterna. Let perpetual light shine upon them, O Lord, with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Grant them eternal rest, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them."
Thank you.
And as I wake, sweet music breathe above, about, or underneath, sent by some spirit to mortals good or the unseen genius of the wood. Let my dew feet never fail to walk the studious cloisters pale and love the high embowed roof with antique pillars, massy proof, and storied windows richly dight, casting a dim religious light. There let the pealing organ blow to the full-voiced choir below, in service high and anthems clear, as may with sweetness through mine ear dissolve me into ecstasies and bring all heaven before mine eyes. When the Lamb had taken the scroll, the four living creatures and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb, each having a harp and golden bowls full of incense, which are the prayers of the saints. And they sang a new song, saying, "You are worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals, for you were slain and have redeemed us to God by your blood. And we shall reign on the earth." Then I looked, and I heard the voice of many angels around the throne, the living creatures and the elders, and the number of them was 10,000 times 10,000, and thousands of thousands, saying with a loud voice, "Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessing." And every creature which is in heaven and on the earth and under the earth and such as are in the sea and all that are in them, I heard saying, "Blessing and honor and glory and power be to him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb forever and ever. Amen."
And I looked and heard the voices of many angels, numbering thousands upon thousands and 10,000 upon 10,000. They encircled the throne and the living creatures and the elders. In a loud voice they sang, "Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and praise. To him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be praise and honor and glory and power forever and ever."
Profoundly for coming to experience this night of music and poetry. The music department wishes to express its sincere gratitude not only to the cathedral, but to our senior pastor, the Reverend Dr. Dwayne Anders, and all of the many people who have worked tirelessly to make this concert happen. Most of them sitting right up here. The various ministries of the Cathedral Music Program are open to people of all ages, nationalities, creeds, and persuasions. If you are at all interested in joining us in making music, we encourage you to either call us during the week or to reach out via email or through our church website contact us form. We would love to have you come and join us. We also invite you to come experience one of our Sunday services at 9, 10, or 11. It's always open to everyone. The concert tonight has been presented free of charge, but we encourage you to express your appreciation by leaving an offering either in the basket that's out in the foyer or by following the instructions on the back of your program if you would prefer to make a donation electronically. We close tonight's concert with two of our choir's favorite pieces from this past year. Once again, we thank you for coming and we wish you a wonderful weekend.
Walk all over God's heaven. blessed weekend.